Among the millions of stars and galaxies that we know of, this small little blue planet called the Earth is the only one known to be endowed with what we call life. It is wrapped around by a thin, seamless web of organisms called biosphere. Man as a species is just a speck in this web. It's another matter that of late man is on a course to gobble the web itself. Man presently apportions about 40% of the Earth's net productivity. In the process, he is erasing the last of the natural habitats of the species. Biodiversity is unevenly distributed across the world. Ever-growing human impacts have accelerated the loss and extinction of biodiversity. Although extinction is a natural process, yet human impacts have increased the rate of extinction by nearly 1,000 times, or possibly several thousand times the natural rate. To focus on the conservation of biodiversity, 34 biodiversity hotspots have been identified globally, which represent the regions of exceptional plant endemism and plagued by serious level of habitat loss. Over 50% of the world's plant species and 42% of all terrestrial vertebrate species are endemic to the 34 biodiversity hotspots. India has 4 biodiversity hotspots, namely the Himalaya, the Indo-Burma, the Western Ghats and Sri Lanka, and the Sundaland, including Andaman and Nicobar Islands. Though India accounts for only 2.4% of the total land area of the world, it represents 8% of the global biodiversity. The floral wealth of India comprises of more than 47,000 species, including 43% of vascular plants. Nearly 147 plant genera are endemic to India. Of the 9 Valvulovian centers of origin of food crops, 2, namely the Hindu Kush and the Indo-Malayan region, are located within the Indian subcontinent. It is estimated that between the year 1600 and 2000, roughly 4,000 species of mammals, 9,000 species of birds, 6,300 species of reptiles, 4,200 species of amphibians, 19,100 species of fishes, 1 million species of invertebrates, and 250,000 species of flowering plants have become extinct. Given the present rate at which we are exterminating species, most of the world's species will become extinct within the next century, thus putting a question mark on the survival of man himself. However, the situation is not hopeless. Despite all the wars, the earthquakes, the famines, and the diseases, the will of man to survive has so far succeeded. The Indian scientific community has been on the forefront of a global movement to arrest the degradation of the Earth's biodiversity. They've made significant contributions in assessing, mapping, utilization, and conservation of biodiversity. This short film showcases the salient features of 5 such biodiversity related research projects.
India is rich in bioresources. The rural population of India is directly linked to these bioresources for its livelihood, traditional knowledge of medicinal plants, economically important species. And these natural ecosystem provide immense ecological services to the entire rural population. Till recently, there has not been a scientific database of these bioresources systematically collected over entire natural landscapes. In 1998, Indian Space Research Organization and Department of Biotechnology took a major initiative wherein it created a database on different vegetation types, and using the landscape ecological principles, it created information on a degree of fragmentation, disturbance regimes, and biological richness. This entire database has been organized in the Biodiversity Information System, and today it has become part of Indian Bioresource Information Network.
Landscapes such as the Himalaya, Central Highlands, Western Ghats, Northeast India represent a mosaic of interacting ecosystems in relatively large to very large areas, consisting of patches of different land use and land covers. Under this project, the biological richness was worked out from a combination of the outputs of different submodels. Based on satellite images, landscape analysis, and field inventory. Through this intricate process, a total of 150 vegetation and land use classes were delineated using on-screen visual interpretation technique. A total of 86 forest classes were mapped, of which 20 were mixed natural formations, 29 were gregarious formations, 21 were locale-specific formations, 13 forest plantation classes, 2 woodland classes, and 15 scrub classes. This was supported by the field inventory of 313,076 individuals, comprising 7,596 plant species from 16,518 nationwide sample plots. The baseline database generated under the project has been made available to the range of users, including forest departments, through the development of a web GIS-enabled information and data retrieval service. The works done at the University of Agriculture, Bangalore are varied and have made significant contribution towards documentation and dissemination of the information on biodiversity, especially in the Western and Eastern Ghats in Southern India. Under this program, the university has developed a number of databases now available in user-friendly CDs. India is a vast, diverse country and home to some of the most important biodiversity hotspots of the world. However, measuring and monitoring biodiversity is complex. Even more complex is its sharing and dissemination to various users.
Biodiversity project is the first of its kind project in India, which was funded by the Department of Biotechnology and the Department of Space of the Government of India. This project, which was conceptualized at Indian Institute of Remote Sensing, was started in 1998 and completed in 2010. About 77 organizations and more than 150 individuals worked in this project continuously for about 12 years. We have created a database which spans into a few terabytes, and this spatial and non-spatial data is available to public through a website called www.bisindia.org. We have published 10 books on the regional plant richness and one national assessment, in addition to CDs, atlases, and the web portal. We have also created another website called Indian Bioresource Information Network, which consists of this database as well as other bioresources database of India.
Under the IBIN project, a web portal has been designed for data organization, services, and dissemination. Eventually, the network would consist of several interacting nodes. One, at University of Agriculture Sciences, Bangalore, serving predominantly non-spatial database, and the other at IIRS Dehradun, mainly providing spatial data sets. The entire IBIN system will be eventually launched on the existing biogrids of the Bioinformatics Network of DBT.
One of the important contributions of DBT funding is creation of this lab, where work is going on from the level of creation of the database and bioresources to their utilization and to conservation. This lab at the University of Agricultural Sciences is the node for the entire country to document and digitize the biological resources of the country. In the first phase, we digitized data on about 40,000 species of plants and animals of the country, including the marine and microbial resources. Now, all this data from about 400 scientists all over the country is brought together on a common platform, which can be searched in different forms. For instance, if one wants to look at the medicinal plants, you know a common name of a medicinal plant. Through this database, you can look at the language that you want to look for, pick that name and the corresponding scientific name, and all the diverse uses that plant is put into, the distribution of this plant in the country, the images of this plant, etc. So, also we have got databases on domestic animals and laboratory animals and figs and frogs and the mammals, reptiles, etc. In addition to that, we have databases on the microbial cultures that we have got in our country, marine resources of the country. So, all put together, perhaps this is the largest database ever compiled anywhere in the world on the bioresources of a country.
India is home to many unique plant and animal species. It is considered the 11th mega biodiversity center of the world, with a share of about 11% of the total plant resources. The enormous ecological diversity of India is comparable with the continental level diversity scales across the world. The rich biodiversity has immense potential for prospecting and utilization. Realizing this, DBT has supported many projects aimed to prospect and utilize country's bioresources. One of the major initiatives underway at the University of Agriculture Sciences, Bangalore, is the effort to prospect plants and insect resources of the Western Ghats for important metabolites. Using effective models, UASB has contributed to identifying alternative plant sources from the Western Ghats of some major drugs and metabolics, such as camptothecin, an anti-cancer alkaloid, and galanthamine, used against Alzheimer's disease.
There is a plant called Mappia fortida, currently known as Notopoditis pneumoniana. This plant yields a very good cancer-curing chemical called camptothecin. Today, camptothecin industry is over $1 billion in the entire globe. And the biggest player for the camptothecin is the China. Fortunately, with our efforts of this particular project, we have been able to identify clones of Notopoditis pneumoniana, which yields a lot of very high concentration of this camptothecin. In the last 6-7 years, we know what is the kind of havoc that bird flu has caused. For bird flu cure, there is a specific molecule called shikimic acid that is important. And shikimic acid is generally supplied by China, and today China is the biggest player. With our efforts in the Western Ghats resource survey, we have been able to identify alternative sources for shikimic acid. One species called Calophyllum apetalum, the leaves contain many folds higher shikimic acid than the Chinese source. To that extent, India is now gearing up with this project, having many more resources, alternative resources for high-value, medicinally important metabolites.
UASB has also launched a unique program of discovering drugs from bugs. Focusing on antimicrobial activity from select insect systems, the university has reported novel antimicrobial peptides that could potentially be of interest in therapeutics. The UASB group has also discovered interesting entomopathogenic activity in soil-dwelling nematodes. While India is endowed with rich biodiversity, there is a growing concern about the increased threat to the bioresources because of forest fragmentation of habitats and over-extraction, as analyzed by Indian Institute of Remote Sensing, Dehradun. A number of medicinally important plants have already become critically endangered or threatened. It is feared that in the absence of any mitigation, these might face the risk of local and even global extinction. Realizing this, the DBT has initiated a network program on species recovery. As a result of this program, 6 endangered species have been successfully restored in their native habitats. The success of this program has led to the development of a more ambitious project to address the recovery of 60 species in the eastern Himalayan range. Finally, as a part of the program and to monitor the genetic diversity of endangered species, for the first time, simple sequence repeat markers have been developed for 10 endangered species, using which genetic hotspots of the species have been mapped.
There is one species called Semicarpus catlecanensis that is found near the very famous Jog Falls in Karnataka state. It's a very big tree that was recently described by botanists about 8 to 10 years back. And today we have less than 120 individuals which are in the breeding condition in the entire Western Ghats. To that extent, in the entire world, because it's an endemic species, we don't have more than 120 breeding individuals. So what we have done is, we have mapped all these 4 populations, collected the seeds, grow the seedlings in the nursery, and then went back to the habitat, which is very typical to that, and we have planted them. And today, I'm very happy to say that more than 5,000 of such seedlings are growing in the wild, making it a very successful species recovery plan.
Stratified random sampling was adopted for analyzing the vegetation composition of all the vegetation types. A 0.1 hectare plot was used for the same. Nested plot sampling was followed. A 31.62 meter by 31.62 meter plot for trees, a 5 meter by 5 meter plot at the center of this plot for shrubs and saplings, and 4 1 meter by 1 meter plots at 4 corners of the same plot were laid. At each sample site, the circumference of trees at breast height was noted. The individuals with more than 30 centimeters CBH were considered as tree, and those between 17 and 29 centimeters CBH as saplings. For shrubs, total numbers of tillers for each species were counted. For herbs, only the number of individuals was recorded. Plant species were identified using taxonomic expertise.